Hitachi model number ED-A100 overhead projector. The problem that I have with it is this mirror opening hinge. It's, if you see it here, it's just flopping about. There's no control over it. I'm just going to power it up now and we'll just listen to it. As you can hear, possibly, I hope the microphone is picking it up. There's a motor buzzing away inside the ear, and that just came down by itself. It just won't come back. What's supposed to happen with these is when you power down, this would go into the closed position, and when you power up, it would open up after a couple of seconds, and then you would see this light reflecting off this mirror assembly here. To get at the mirror assembly, there's that mortar assembly inside. It's a bit difficult. I'm just going to go through the process. First of all, I'm going to power off the unit. And there's a screw here, and let's see which one it is. I think this is it. That's got to come off first. Close the mirror. And then we have lots of screws on the bottom. I can't get at these with the power screwdriver. The bit is not long enough to get into these deep holes. Make sure I've got everything. Filter. Now, if I have all the screws out, it should pop out. And now I've just got to remove this cover here, and there's three screws. Okay, here, see, can I get a better look at? Around so you can have a look. Inside this little housing, there's a slip and clutch. It's probably for safety, just in case it comes against anything and it doesn't wreck all the gears. But that clutch breaks up inside here, and you can't buy that clutch, as far as I know, separately. You have to buy the whole hinge drive motor assembly. I just, to get at that drive motor assembly, I have to take out the whole optical engine. And to get the optical engine out, I got to take out this top PCB. I can just open up this here, He said there's six screws here, and this whole lot will pop off here, and I will be able to show you the clutch where it's broke up. But for now, let's just carry on removing the optical assembly. There's some screws here down the side. Them and remove all the cables from the top. Two screws, silver, and they got little washers on them as well. And there seem to be holes in another one, and a missed one silver screw. And another one. More cables here, and then we got these connectors here that go down to the optical engine. Push back the clips and it should come out no problem. Still got one cable or something holding it in place. Oh, see, down here I'm going to have to reposition the camera for this. Okay, that might be able to get it. Down here we have a screw that holds this bracket in. I'll remove that pole bracket. Little silver screw with a washer on it. We just put that to one side. Now that's that loose. Okay. We're going to start removing this optical engine now, and it's held in by numerous black screws, self tappers, and I'm going to start that. Another one down here. And there's another one right down here. I'm going to remove this bracket here on the right hand side. It's held in by two screws, one black self tapper located nearest the cooling fan, and then on here where it's mounted onto this bracket here, it's a silver screw, and it's got a little washer on it as well, and that comes out. And that is the orientation of it going in. these wires out of the way. And I'll just loosen this screw on this bracket and get it out of the way. And take this steel bracket out as well. There's a self-tapping screw down here, black. And that just pulls out. And that's the orientation it goes back in. Okay. Silver screw this side. And it looks like a black self-tapper down this side. Now, we also have a little earth strap here, which looks like an earth strap. And the silver screw down there, right down beside the hinge motor assembly. Silver screw with a little wash on it. Take out the bracket. And that's the orientation of it going in. Okay, let's see how this will move now. Okay, there's one more screw right down here. Right beside there's a post here. Self-tapper. Okay. It won't come out, it looks like, until we have this lamp assembly out. Undo the two screws of that. Let's see what happens. And that's it out. Here I have the optical assembly out of the unit, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to just concentrate on that here for now. We're just going to take this out and I will show you the problem. This whole unit will come off as an assembly if you just take out the black screws, the three black screws, and then there's two silver screws down here. But because I want to show you the problem, I'm just going to remove the six screws out. Now, these three black screws are the ones that hold the assembly to the hinge. Okay. Let's see, can I get a little bit closer without losing my focus? I think that's as close as I'll get. As you can see here, the mirror assembly moves up and down, but this here is not turning. This here should turn with the mirror assembly. And I'm going to see, can I prise out that? Will it come out? Or will I have to take the whole motor assembly apart? Okay, not coming out. Okay, what I'll do is I'll just take these six screws off here. were just six screws that were on the housing of the they just retain the housing. Off. Let's see, can we get it? We're still in shot. So gonna get this out. This here is the slip and clutch, and it is actually that inner part of the clutch is actually cracked. I don't know if the camera's able to pick that up or not. But there's the problem. Move the hole. There's two screws up here at the top. And that whole unit comes as an assembly. Comes like that with the clutch. Everything in it, and we can't buy the separate gears for this because they're not available, unfortunately. The only place I can get that load and mortar assembly is from Hitachi. If you have an account with Hitachi, you might be able to get it there. And the only numbers I've got on it is 840-JS-77-689. And I've also seen it available in a company called Charles Hyde. Now, they're normally fairly expensive, but it is available in Charles Hyde. And the number they have, their stock number is 12030-EK. When you get your load mortar, it comes as a whole assembly. Of course, it's got to be lined up with this the little slots on this shaft, and then reassembly is only reverse of this assembly. It's straightforward enough. I hope that's of some help out there to you. Thanks for watching.